I went to college, I went to Brown University, and I wasn't sure what I wanted to do, and I wasn't sure what I wanted to major in. I discovered that I loved the classes in religious studies because those classes taught me how to ask questions, and I love asking questions. You could call me nosy, but I love asking questions, and I love learning just the right way to ask questions. Those classes also taught me how to write, because I had to write many, many papers. And I happened to have one teacher who mentored me and helped me with my writing, and both in the class and outside the class, and she became a friend. I wanted to be a writer, but I didn't think just a regular person like me who grew up in Allentown, Pennsylvania, could be a writer. All the people in college who were going to be writers wore all black and smoked cigarettes and used big words that I did not understand and drank endless cups of coffee. Well, I drank coffee. I would never smoke a cigarette, ever, ever. And I tend to use words that most people can understand. So I thought, well, I guess I can't be a writer. But I still really wanted to be one. I got a job right out of college working for a Jewish magazine. I sort of got in through the back door. I had done some freelance writing in college, but mostly I think I got the job because they thought I would be a good person to fetch the coffee. I did a pretty good job at doing that. But I also got to do some writing. And I loved that, but I wasn't doing enough writing, and I knew now that I really wanted to be a writer. I was fortunate enough to meet a wonderful man who lived in New York, and I wanted to move to New York to be with him. I went looking for a job, and I got an interview at Scholastic Magazines. There was a job opening on the fourth grade magazine called Scholastic News Explorer. I had never thought about writing for children. I thought, well, it would get me to New York, and then I could get a better job. So I got the interview. I got along very well with the editor, and he gave me an assignment. Sometimes when you get a job, when you're applying for a job, you have to do a trial assignment. And he gave me an assignment. It was to write about panda bears being endangered. It was an article about a little boy who went to Anwar Sadat's funeral. Anwar Sadat was the president, premier of Egypt. And I also had to come up with a list of ideas that I thought would be good articles for fourth graders. And I thought, well, I don't know. How am I going to know? I went back up to Boston, and I have to say that it was so easy for me. It was as if I was back in fourth grade. I just knew how to write those articles, and I just came up with a list of, he said, give me 10, 15 ideas. I think I had 30 ideas for articles just like that. And so I got the job. I never knew I wanted to write for children, and the minute I started, I loved it. And I also would say that working at Scholastic was an fantastic training ground, because soon after I got there, the magazines reorganized. So I was writing for first graders all the way up to sixth graders. So we were writing for all these different editions, and our deadlines were fast and furious. So in the morning, I would have to write about Ms. Pac-Man, that dates this, Ms. Pac-Man for first graders and second graders. And in the afternoon, I would have to write about Rachel Carson and pesticides for fifth and sixth graders. So it was a great, great training ground, and I had really good colleagues and editors there.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Anne B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.